So in today's class, you are going to learn about the general entries on the revaluation accounts. You know, the revaluation account is also called as profit and loss adjustment account. So this revaluation account prepared at the time of admission, retirement and death of a partner. Now, so general entries: increase in the value of assets. Next, decrease in the value of assets. Increase in the amount of liability. Decrease in the amount of liability. For unrecorded assets. Next, for unrecorded liabilities. And revaluation account profit or loss. Now, you know the format of profit and loss adjustment account. So this is the format. So debit side, you are going to record the expenses and the losses. Expenses and losses, and credit side incomes and gains. So this is profit and loss adjustment account format. So PL, profit and loss adjustment account, it shows the increase and decrease in the value of assets and liabilities, and this account prepared at the time of reconstitution of a partnership firm. Now, so increase in the value of assets, if assets increases. So in profit and loss adjustment account, if assets increases, we'll record a credit side, but in general entry, so it comes a debit side. So the general entry, increase in the value of asset account data to revaluation account. Asset account data to revaluation account. Now you know this is revaluation account. So this is revaluation account. So under revaluation account, if assets increases, we'll record credit side. But in general entry, opposite here. So asset account data to revaluation account. So in case of increase in the value of assets. Next, decrease in the value of assets. Decreasing in the value of assets. So under revaluation account, will record the debit side, but in general entry, so credit side. So revaluation account, debit to asset account. Decrease in the value of assets. Decrease in the value of assets. So in general entry, revaluation account data to asset account. So in ledger, we'll take opposite, because you know the journal, ledger means posting from a journal to ledger, opposite side. So here opposite asset will record it, debit side, and revaluation account data to asset account. Next, increase in the amount of liability. Increase in the amount of liability. So under revaluation accounts, increase in the amount of liability will be recorded debit side, that is expenses and losses. So general entry, so credit side here. So revaluation account debit, so to liability account. liability account. Increase in the amount of liability, so is an expenses. So the general entry, so revaluation account debtor to liability account. Next, decrease in the amount of liability. Decrease in the amount of liability is an income. So here under revaluation account we will record the credit side, but in general entry debit side. So liability account debit, so to revaluation account. So decrease the amount of liability, general entry liability account debit to revaluation account. So under revaluation account, so liability we have to record the credit side. Next, for unrecorded assets. Unrecorded assets means the assets not recorded in the books. Unrecorded assets. So unrecorded assets in revaluation account will record the credit side. So here debit side. Asset account debit. Asset account debit. So to revaluation account. So this is a general entry for the unrecorded assets. Asset account debit. So to revaluation account. Next, for unrecorded liabilities. For the unrecorded liability. Unrecorded liability under the revaluation accounts, we are going to record the debit side, that is under expenses and the losses. So here the opposite side here. So revaluation account debit to liability account. So for unrecorded liability, general entry revaluation account debit to liability account. Next, so after the preparing revaluation account, so revaluation account we have to close by transferring the net profit or a net loss. So in case of admission of a partner, in case of admission of a partner, so if there is a profit, if there is a profit entry, so profit on revaluation, so difference amount will get the debit side. While closing a revaluation account, we are going to distribute the revaluation account profit or loss among the old partners in case of a admission of a partner. So profit, so here you will share among the old partners. So this is under revaluation account debit side. So in case of a general entries, so credit side we have to record, that is old partners revaluation account debit to older partners capital account. So if there is a profit, so under revaluation account profit you will get debit side. So this profit we have to share among the old partners in their old ratio, the same year. So the general entry revaluation account data to old partners capital account. Next, in case of a loss, in case of a loss, so loss you will get a credit side on the revaluation accounts. So loss also will share among the old partners in the old ratio, but general entry debit side, old partners capital account debit, old partners capital account debit. So two, revaluation account. Two, revaluation account. So this is in case of a admission of a partner. Under retirement of a partner, this revaluation account profit or a loss will share among the all the partners. Now it's clear that general entries on the revaluation account, that is on profit or loss adjustment account. So